Yep, and once again, Method Black, they're trying to find an answer for the Windwalker Death Knight of Wildcard Gaming, and they may have found one with the Frostmage Windwalker Monk, but unfortunately for them, Wildcard Gaming, they read their hand, and they know exactly what to run, and that is going to be that Elemental Shaman Moonkin Restoration Druid. I'm still not 100% sold on this composition. Method Black could definitely still win this one.
Yeah, this isn't a matchup that we get to see very often, but Wildcard Gaming dodge a bullet by avoiding this Windwalker Mage. They would typically want to be playing their Mistweaver Windwalker Death Knight, but we've seen that this Windwalker Frost Mage is able to actually deal with it quite effectively. So Wildcard Gaming anticipated Method Black using this to counter comp their main composition and then locked in this Elemental Shaman Balance Druid to try and get an advantage through this manner. But we still aren't 100% sold or confident in this composition's capability after its performance yesterday on Never Lucky. It looked kind of shaky, but of course, Z-Pi is one of the best elemental shamans across the globe, so potentially going to be showing us that this composition packs a little bit more punch.
Yeah, definitely. We'll have to see what exactly Waz can get done on that Windwalker Monk. I don't think we've seen him on Windwalker Monk for quite some time. It might have been last year is the first time or the last time that we saw him. Chaz moving in, looking for some crowd control. Finds a Cyclone onto Looney. Unfortunately, was denied by Z-Pi. Really good backup. Z-Pi always backing up his team with really well-timed grounding totems and earth shocks to slow down a lot of that crowd control. And that's going to be his role in this particular match. It's going to be up to Maro and Z-Pi to make sure Raikou can never really find opportunities to land polymorphs onto Looney. And that's what's so difficult for the Frost Mage in this particular matchup. You have Looney, who's a Restoration Druid with an Elemental Shaman backing him up, so getting Polymorphs on him is not an easy job. And then Maro, of course, on that Moonkin. With Moonkin form, he's going to be immune to Polymorphs, so a lot of that Frost Mage control is not going to be really benefiting Method Black in this particular matchup.
Which is why we see Maro as the target of choice for Method Black. That way they can still access the Polymorph Diminishing Return on at least one member of the team, that being Z-Pi. I'm curious to see what the strategy is here for Wildcard Gaming. Early on, it appears that they're just focusing on deflecting Waz, trying to keep him at bay with pressure, potentially punch through for a kill if he's not careful. One big Earth Shock, and it could just be a KO for him, so he definitely needs to be aware of that while he's pushing forward. After Looney comes out of this Cyclone, I'm curious to see what the mana situation is, if there's any lead establishing itself there. Definitely in favor of Wildcard Gaming. Pressure on both Raikou and Waz. I'm wondering how much Z-Pi is utilizing the recent changes to the reductions in mana cost on Purge, if this is why Chaz is struggling so much more so on mana than that of Looney.
Yeah, I mean, that could definitely be a huge factor in this particular matchup. I think Restoration Druids are one of the healers that might struggle with something like Purge being on a lower mana cost, as well as the Dispel Magic from the Shadow Priest and Discipline Priest. We have yet to see that really play out too much in favor of the Discipline Priest, Shadow Priest, and Elemental Shaman, but like we've sort of said, Chaz behind on mana at this point in the game. I'm not sure if he's ever going to be able to really sneak away. It seems like Z-Pi's been doing a really good job making sure he stays in combat. They have good, consistent pressure in this matchup, and speaking as a Windwalker Monk, it can be very difficult, especially if Waz is not running the Tiger Eye Brew specialization, to take down a target like a Moonkin. And when he does go into Bear Form, he's going to have heavy armor, and Windwalker Monks don't exactly have a lot of damage that goes through those high armor targets, so it can be difficult, and the damage you're able to put out is very limited.
Waz looks like he wants to start pressuring Looney a bit, but is going to be pulling back. Having realized that Chaz and Raikou repositioned, they would be overextending quite heavily. I'm curious to see how well Wildcard Gaming can deny Chaz from regenerating his mana on drink attempts. That's going to be the name of the game for Wildcard Gaming. Focus on defense, get your setups on the Lightning Lasso, and burn down Chaz's mana as fast as Teldrassil. Looney jumping to Maro to try and get to safety. Manages to reposition, avoiding any sort of double stun. Raikou gets bursted pretty hard here early on. Chaz denies it with Iron Bark. That should buy time for Raikou to counterattack. We see pressure on Maro. How is Looney going to respond? So far, only exchanging the Innervate, at least getting a couple powerful heals for free, but likely we will see a cooldown forced here, and if it's underreacted, possibly a kill. Looney now gets swapped too, caught into a bash, pressure onto two members of the team. Looney once again reluctant to make a trade on cooldowns, remaining calm, cool, and calculated, not overextending his defensive lineup whatsoever. Waz now getting bursted. Chaz's mana still significantly behind, and Wildcard Gaming continue to march forward with their advantage.
Yeah, definitely. Wildcard Gaming is looking very good in this matchup. Raikou with his Icy Veins wasn't able to get a whole bunch done. Maro looking to get aggressive right now with his Incarnation, but Raikou is doing a really good job. You can see his positioning right now, making sure he's always weaving in and out of the pillar to avoid the damage Maro can really put out. Raikou trying to build up significant burst now by just spamming up some Frostbolts. And if they can get some good crowd control onto Looney with all that Frost Mage damage ready and available, they might be able to actually burst Maro down. He gets offensively cycloned and interrupted. Raikou really just going for raw damage at this point in the match, not looking for crowd control. Looney, in the meantime, sitting down for a drink. He has full faith in the fact that Maro's going to be able to stay alive, especially with some of the off-healing Z-Fi has available. Now Wildcard Gaming is in an opportunity Ooh. Where they completely reset their mana.
That Ring of Peace from Waz missed Looney. He was able to regenerate to full mana and establish a huge lead just as Dampening enters the fight. Exactly what Wildcard Gaming needed to get even further ahead. Z-Fi going for a Lightning Lasso. Tons of damage tossed towards Raikou. I do like the coordinated effort between Maro and Z-Fi. Maro is always saving his Astral Power to combine with the Lightning Lasso. This way, their otherwise very low sustained damage is then more effective combined together with Burst on the Lightning Lasso. They're playing this a lot more coordinated than the previous Elemental Shaman Boomkins that we have seen, trying to capitalize on as much Burst damage as possible. Waz taken fairly low. Iron Bark appears to be enough for Chaz to recover. He's trying to sneak away. Maro sees that, and the other advantage of this composition is access to a spell called Starfall, but Chaz expects Maro to Starfall that pillar, so Chaz repositions in stealth. Z-Pi knows he's in stealth and picks up the Shadow Sight crystal to try and find him. Z-Pi is now hunting Chaz. Everything is all about Z-Pi stopping Chaz from jinking. Chaz is still not sat down, realizing that Z-Pi can see him. He may not even be able to find any sort of opportunity, at least managing to regen some mana just from being out of combat, but still significantly behind.
Yeah, definitely. Looney pushing in. He's playing that Feral Affinity. He gets a stun onto Raikou, so if Looney can never get out of combat, go into cat form, he can consistently stun up the enemy team of Method Black with that very precious Feral Affinity, but it does make him vulnerable as a target. So I think if Waz and Raikou, they can find an all-in attempt on Looney, if Raikou can pool a lot of his damage, like the Frozen Orb, Comet Storm, Ice Nova, and Waz can save his touch of death, they might be able to just take down Looney through everything, especially without that frenzied regen, that Guardian Affinity. That could be an opening for Method Black, but right now what they're doing, going after Maro, it's just not working out.
Oh, they're pressuring Waz as Chaz has been trying to sit down and regenerate mana throughout, but now costing huge defensive cooldowns right as Dampening starts to hit critical mass. This spells devastation for Method Black. The pressure's really on to Chaz. How much longer can he keep his team alive? They've got Touch of Death and Icy Veins. They've got one big swing left to try and throw at Wildcard Gaming. Potentially they could 100-0 Z-Pi with no trinket. That's only really one opportunity I'm seeing right now for their team. Currently pinned at the pillar. Z-Pi, Maro, triangle position. Looney sits down for a drink to further establish the mana advantage. Waz tries to find him, manages to, but it's already too little too late. That's a significant lead for Wildcard Gaming. Raikou's going to pull the trigger on Icy Veins and try and get a kill here. Looney denies it with Iron Bark. Fortunately, Waz and Raikou have split up their Touch of Death and Icy Veins, so there will be another attempt for Waz to make a big push. But if they cannot get that swing, they are all getting whittled down by Wildcard Gaming's consistent pressure.
Yeah, once again, a stun going out onto Waz. He has Touch of Death rolling right now, but Maro, he just cyclones it up. Waz really not going to get too much value from that major offensive cooldown. Really good control here from Wildcard Gaming. Maro now getting bursted down. Raikou trying to do everything he can to start generating some pressure for his team, but Z-Pi forces him to retreat back to the pillar out of line of sight. Like you said, Sid, both Raikou, Waz, they're rotting down. Waz now caught into a full stun. How much damage do they really have available? Z-Pi trying to take him down, but I think Waz should ultimately survive. He has to defuse magic, overlap with a touch of karma. Chaz, in the meantime, hasn't really been able to sneak away and get a drink. So normally when your teammate has those defensive cooldowns available as a healer, you want to try to go and escape and get some mana back. But Method Black has been fortunate in finding those opportunities.
Yeah, Maro and Z-Pi have good positioning, constantly denying Method Black's drink attempts. This was a nice read on the blind pick, expecting Method Black, because they've been struggling so much with the Windwalker Death Knight, expecting Method Black to lock in a counter to that, and then picking the counter to that counter. Wildcard Gaming winning the mind game here in game number one, and it could all come down to that blind pick victory, so that should this series swing to a game five, they will have the map advantage and the comp advantage. So moving forward, if these teams go head-to-head in the next series, assuming that Method Black can't swing it back on a swing match, this blind pick is going to get even more interesting. We may see some even more peculiar compositions in the future. Waz is in trouble. Chaz has basically absolutely no mana left. Just cowering in bear form at the pillar, trying to recover as much health as possible with Ysera's Gift, but even that likely to not be enough. Waz is trying to make a push. They have basically no aggressive cooldowns to try and knock Wildcard Gaming down at this point. They're just taking more damage than they can deal. They're still stuck at the pillar. Earthquake ticking away. Maru in position with Starfall. Incarnation coming up in 20. Stormkeeper already available. Touch of Karma 5 seconds away if ZPI wants to go for that move. 4 seconds until that opportunity may be lost. Waz gets hexed up. Raikou with the Dispel. Chaz managed to get mana back, surprisingly, amidst all of that. Maybe a bit of a blunder on the side of Wildcard Gaming that will allow Method Black a little bit longer of a leash.
Yeah, definitely. We'll have to see what exactly can happen. 32% dampening, but Waz and Raikou, they need to start finding pressure in this matchup. Now looking for a big all-in attempt onto Maru, getting the Frozen Orb, but not too much else. There is Touch of Death still available, as well as the Icy Veins at 15. Maybe Raikou and Waz, they want to try to get an all-in push with those two offensives. Chaz rotting down. ZPI, Maru still generating a lot of pressure for the team. This is Maru's incarnation as he's looking to get really aggressive. This is the Touch of Death. Waz getting bursted down in a Lightning Lasso. Is he going to be able to get Karma off? Does manage to find it, making a push in the middle of the map with that cooldown, caught into a Hex, caught into a Cycle, and such good control coming in from Wildcard Gaming. They're just denying Method Black at every opportunity.
Yeah, another opportunity to take out Waz. Gladiator's Maledict gets to defuse magic off. Waz holds on a bit longer. Chess still, that drink that he got earlier is the only thing keeping their team in the match. Maybe they could potentially pull off a miracle. There's decent pressure on Maru. He's trying to retreat away, gets Ring of Peace back into midfield for Raikou to tee off. Raikou trying to sneak in a Polymorph on Looney. Looney not falling for it. Waz gets bursted. He ports nowhere. That mistake is going to cost Method Black game number one.
Oh, ports, man.
Out mind gaming Method Black, but now Method Black, they have an opportunity to strike back in game number two. This is their map pick on Ashmane's Fall, as well as their compositional advantage. We'll have to see what they can get done.
Looks like Raikou is employing that Mana Rift strategy, immediately going after Looney, and that is going to be very difficult for him to deal with throughout the fight. Fortunately, bringing in a Balanced Druid and an Elemental Shaman, he will have access to Cyclone and Hex. Chaz not playing the Restoration Druid, will not be able to remove the Hex. There's already just good damage on Looney. I'm surprised to see this much pressure from Raikou early on. Looney has that Gladiator Safeguard. Proc moves in with Way of the Crane, trying to add some damage. Maybe he's running the Grapple Weapon. That could be a strategy with the two wizards to try and blast Swapsy down in a Lightning Lasso into a Grapple Weapon. I'm curious to see if that is something that Wildcard Gaming intend to employ here strategically. That would be one way for them to get around the Deathstrike.
Yeah, I mean, we'll have to see if they can get that done. Chaz throwing out the Lightning Cocoon to counteract the Lightning Lasso of ZPI on Raikou. Raikou manages to stay alive. Swapsy trades out his anti-magic shell. For pressure, it seems relatively even, but that was a lot of the offensive cooldowns available for Wildcard Gaming. That was the incarnation, and they really didn't get too much. The anti-magic zone is a good trade for Swapsy. He's always going to have that available as long as he waits for it. Life Cocoon, a short cooldown for Chaz, so Method Black is in a favorable position right now.
The mana rifts keep coming. Looney trinkets out to avoid this one. Raikou overextends and gets stunned up by Maru, then cycloned at low health when Chaz wanted to connect some heals. Chaz is also playing the Gnome Mistweaver Monk, which is why we typically don't see a lot of gnomes, but they are very effective against balanced druids, especially as a healer. So it's to avoid the entangling root solar beam combination of crowd control, which could be a win condition. This is a huge amount of pressure, a very unexpected amount of pressure from Wildcard Gaming when facing this composition that Method Black had brought forward. And they're taking full advantage of the map. If Looney can maintain his mana as healthy as he is so far, I actually think they're going to take this.
Yeah, things are looking really good for Wildcard Gaming right now. And this has been a kind of a question for us. Is Chaz on the Mistweaver Monk? And in addition to that, ZPI on the Elemental Shaman, he always seems to make it work when other Shaman cannot, which is definitely something Wildcard Gaming has in their favor, especially with some of the purge changes. If he's just purging off all the Renewing Mist Chaz has available, it might be difficult for Chaz and something he hasn't really had to deal with on that Mistweaver Monk.
Solar Beam landed on Chaz's cast. Now into a Bash. Good crowd control from Maru. Look, gets the Cyclone off the back end of that chain. Forces the Glider's Medallion even lower on health. Now Cyclone rotated to Raikou. And this is why, like, Maru is so good on Balancer as well, taking his knowledge and experience on Mage, really getting good, effective crowd control and setting up burst moments, really shining on the team of Wildcard Gaming right now. Definitely one of his best performances on Balanced Druid so far. Perhaps this composition is going to work out for Wildcard Gaming throughout the series. Looney is actually ahead on mana, which is not supposed to be the case when facing Mana Rift Demon Hunters.
Yeah, but the problem is, Raikou, he's just been pressured so much in this matchup, Now trading out his Blur, running in once again to the pillar. He's in some trouble. Looney's trying to close out the game. Beautiful ring of peace, knocking him back in line of sight of Zeepi, of Maro. What is Raikou going to do? Trying to keep himself alive with that metamorphosis. Pressuring down, anti-magic zone gets traded out once again by Swapsy, but that's too early. Now Maro, there's a huge opportunity in 6 seconds. Incarnation's coming up, and Wildcard Gaming could potentially take Raikou down.
Jazz is just getting bodied with crowd control so far in game number two, and Wildcard Gaming are taking full advantage of that fact. This could easily be it for Raikou as he gets bursted down and gets KO'd. Wildcard Gaming, we thought this composition stood no chance whatsoever in the current meta.
Probably gets together. They're in a call, and they're just like, okay, how are we going to destroy them in the blind pick? And they just spend all of their time deciding how to dismantle Method Black. They're going to try to get the 3-0 here on Ruins of Lordaeron.
All right, Ruins of Lordaeron, as it is a cemetery, would be a fitting final resting place, and we're going to have to wait and see if Zeepi ends up being that weak link.
Oh, stolen joke. And this is Ruins of Lordaeron. It could potentially be a fitting final resting place for Method Black if they can't get it done here in game number three. We're going to be stealing jokes. Two can play that game.
And guys, dude, keep in mind, as you see some pressure going out into Zeepi, he's going to be in that life cocoon. He could be the weak link.
All right, match point for Wildcard.
The show, man.
I know. Wildcard Gaming up 2-0 in this series with a composition that we basically counted out entirely yesterday, and already bursting Raikou down heavily, forcing multiple defensive cooldowns early on for Method Black. Finally, some counter aggression on to Maro. It does appear that Method Black are focusing much more so on just raw pressure on Maro rather than only the mana rift strategy. Looney now with Way of the Crane is going to be adding some extra damage. He gets imprisoned away, but Raikou just gets destroyed by Zeepi right now. Anti-magic zone is exchanged. Raikou is just leaving its defense. We saw this cost the game. The Ring of Peace is denying him being able to reconnect into it, but with the Soul Leech healing, appears to be more than enough to recover and stabilize. However, Chaz playing on this Druid, you can already see the mana advantage establishing itself for Wildcard Gaming, and on Ruins of Lordaeron, I feel like it'll be very easy for Maro and Zeepi to stop him from drinking, and I can't help but feel that Method Black should have pulled out their Rogue Mage when facing this composition. It's already spiraling out of control.
Still though, even with Chaz going to be on that healer, you know, we really saw him try to branch out in game number two. It's nice to see him back on his roots, and I think he should be able to stave off this aggression.
Goodness gracious, what is going on? Full stun onto Zeepi. Good pressure here for Method Black. No defensive cyclone coming in from Chaz as well, slowing down some of the healing Looney has available. If we look at mana, this is what I was kind of afraid of. Although Raikou and Swapsy, they're putting out good pressure on Zeepi and Maro, they haven't really been landing too many mana rifts onto Looney. Finally, one's going to land onto Looney, getting a little bit of his mana down. Way of the Crane activated. Raikou taking a huge burst of damage. Activates Blur to save his life, but Chaz mana is not doing well. Already around 60%. Right now he's in stealth, trying to sneak away and get a drink. I think Zeepi is going to be able to easily shut that down. You can see him patrolling right now. As soon as Chaz gets out of stealth, I think it's likely Zeepi will deny his drink. Maro in a good position as well, and that's really what it's going to come down to for Wildcard Game. Oh. If you deny the drinks, then they're going to have a favorable matchup, but if the Black can sneak away, it's going to be bad for them.
Maro got stun locked a couple inches away from denying the drink, which now allows Chaz to reset his mana pool. Very important for the team of Method Black moving forward should they want to rely on Mana Rift and this mana burn strategy for victory. Crowd control onto Chaz. Maro is doing a great job at balancing his crowd control and his burst. Curious to see if he can pull through for another victory. We've seen Chaz consistently getting controlled in that last game. Now on Druid, has a bit easier of a time avoiding it, but still could be a liability if he is caught off guard. Swapsy gets swapped too. What was that hit? 10% health remaining, and then an immediate top off from Chaz. So not so scary anymore, but...
Hello, Zeepi.
I mean, if that happens again, one less heal over time effect, Chaz isn't ready for it, or gets crowd controlled for even a millisecond, I think Wildcard Gamer are going to clean sweep this.
Yeah, I mean, things are looking good, especially if they can pull off that kind of burst damage. But mana now in favor of Method Black in this matchup. Let's see what they can get done. Swapsy getting a little bit low right now. Trades out the Icebound Fortitude. Chaz caught into a stun. Big aggressive plays here by Maro. Swapsy could be in some trouble.
Ring of Peace.
Trades out the anti-magic zone. Ring of Peace denies that actually a little bit there. But Swapsy does manage to find his way back into the safety of that cooldown. A defensive cycle coming in with a full hex on Chaz. Whoa. Beautiful crowd control from Wildcard Gaming. Swapsy has to hold on. Should be able to do so with the anti-magic tell and some death strikes, but the Wildcard Gaming
Chaz is getting
so
owned.
Well.
Chaz is just getting destroyed right now. I've never seen Chaz get played like this before in a tournament setting. Wildcard Gaming are all over him. Total control. This is a matchup that I did not expect to be one-sided in favor of Wildcard Gaming at all. Finally, some counter-aggression here with crowd control on Looney. Morrow gets bursted down to half, but appears to be all right. Cyclone on Raikou. Curious to see who Wildcard Gaming are going to go after next, if they're going to continue after Swapsy. This is the closest we've seen a Death Knight come to dying before dampening, and if Looney maintains his mana, it's likely that we will be able to see them even get to deep dampening. And if you're Method Black, that's getting scary. Chaz is stunned up. Raikou gets bursted. Stun on the follow-up by Looney. Great follow-up. Way of the Crane adding a ton of damage. Raikou on the run. He's trying to get out of line of sight, but Looney's in hot pursuit. It's three members of Wildcard Gaming. Chaz needs to recover with not much defense available. Actually swapping to Looney, trying to punish his push. But now Raikou gets peeled away by Morrow. Once again, good teamwork on the side of Wildcard Gaming.
Yeah, Looney does manage to portal away with that Transcendence. Actually drops a Ring of Peace. Gonna be looking to get a drink right now, but Swapsy immediately shuts it down. You can see him in a great position. Looney still way ahead on mana, though. Once again, Chaz, he might have to sneak away and get some drinks. Swapsy's getting taken down quite quickly as he makes a push onto Looney, but that's the problem. With Raikou and Swapsy, they go after Looney. Morrow, Zipai, they're able to easily punish him. Wildcard Gaming with great positioning in this matchup, making it easy for Looney to sit back, heal, and then when he needs to play catch up, he can use that Way of the Crane, get a lot of burst damage for his team, in addition to easily top everyone off.
All right, Swapsy still the target of choice here. Double stun combo. Wildcard Gaming are just insane. Typically, we see this Elemental Shaman Boomkin comp play a boring strategy of just hiding at the pillar, running around, and trying just to live and do as much damage as possible. But they are coordinating defense and offense so perfectly together in tandem that they're making it look like they basically counter Method Black with this current composition. Zipai moves over, denies the drink. How much did Chaz get, though? He was down for a while. He may have been able to regenerate a significant amount as dampening ramps, and it's that magic number, that 40% mark. Although with this team, maybe it's 20% to take out Swapsy. Chaz needs to get ready for that. Looney now goes for a drink, but they're pressuring Morrow, and Chaz is looking to deny it. Morrow needs to be careful. If Looney gets crowd controlled on his way back, it could be devastating. Looney moves back in line of sight, chucks out that life cocoon, and then immediately line of sights any incoming crowd control, stabilizing the team. They set up a swap to Chaz. Wildcard Gaming continue to mix it up.
Yeah, Chaz under pressure right now. Barskin was used, no trinket available. Frenzied regen should be enough to keep him alive, but that was a great attempt by Wildcard Gaming. Like you said, keeping Method Black on their toes, keeping them guessing, but Method Black has found some pressure in this matchup as well. Looney consistently looking for drinks. That's an opportunity for Swapsy Raikou to start getting some damage rolling onto Zipai, onto Morrow. Mana still in favor of Wildcard Gaming, though, and Looney really, his only opportunity to drink in this matchup with the way Method Black is playing it is with that
Ring of Peace.
In the meantime, big damage on Raikou.
Ring of Peace knocks Raikou out of the defense of that anti-magic zone, and Wildcard Gaming have crafted a composition that could totally dominate Method Black here in the upper bracket. Crowd control secured at low health. Mana advantage significantly in favor of Wildcard Gaming. Way of the Crane available. Swapsy's getting destroyed. Anti-magic shield appears to be enough for him to stabilize. Morrow stabilizes with Life Cocoon as Looney tried to sneak away. I don't think he has that much opportunity, though. Morrow's under too much fire. Looney moves in. This could be the last push of the match if they want to commit that Way of the Crane. They go for it, but Raikou denies it. Looney trinkets out. He could get punished on his trinket. Where's the punish from Method Black? Doesn't look like they have it. Looney rolls over, tries to stop Chaz from drinking. He doesn't know where he is. They manage to find it. Swapsy gets bursted down. The Lightning Lasso combo. Double stun. Crowd control looks solid. Swapsy trades, but it's a little bit late. He manages to recover, but 20% more dampening. That Death Strike is not going to allow him to recover like that again, and they still have the mana advantage.
Yep, definitely, and they've been doing a much better job making sure Chaz can't sneak away for those drinks. Looney a little bit vulnerable right now with no Life Cocoon for another, I guess, only 6 seconds. Once that's up, I think Wildcard Gaming is going to be A-OK. Swapsy with not too much defense.
Oh!
Getting bursted down. Lower and lower. No anti-magic shell. Ironbark trades out from Chaz. Swapsy trying to get out of line of sight, but the Lightning Lasso might have taken him down. Good bash by Chaz. Realizing he probably couldn't heal through the damage. He had no choice but to stop the Lightning Lasso. That was a really good read. It was one of the only reasons Swapsy's still alive.
Wildcard Gaming are thirsty for blood here in game number 3, and also thirsty for mana. Looney just drank back to full. This is a huge advantage for Wildcard Gaming. as we get closer to that magic 40% mark. Uni pulls the trigger on Way of the Crane. That's going to add a huge amount of damage that Chaz does not have the mana to deal with. All three members of Wildcard Gaming are just going right through Swapsy. Chaz still crowd controlled. Nothing left. Retreating back for two more seconds. Needs to make it to the anti-magic zone, but Ring of Peace could deny it. Does he have the Death's Advance to remove the knockback effect? Mara gets pressure, but Swapsy's still low. Who's going to fall first? Anti-magic zone. Where's the Ring of Peace? He gets thunderstormed out of it by Z-Pi. Great knockbacks. Good denial. Swapsy makes his way back in. But Stormkeeper almost closing it out. Chaz manages to recover and stall the fight out a bit longer, but we are now 12% away from that 40% magic number. And at that point, if you're Swapsy, you're not getting out of this alive.
I mean, Chaz, look at his mana. There's nothing left for Chaz. If he can sneak away for a drink, it's going to be huge. Z-Pi has to deny it. Chaz is going to recover so much of his mana. He literally had nothing. Oh, this is a blunder for Wildcard Gaming. You're going to be able to recover a lot. And now Wildcard Gaming is actually falling a little bit behind, even on mana now. Both teams are. Maro down to 40% health. Looney with not too much to keep him alive. Might have to use that Way of the Crane, but that is such an expensive spell. Wildcard Gaming, if they consistently have to rely on that Way of the Crane, they could be burning through their mana so quickly.
All right, let's see. Wildcard Gaming are so close to being able to find victory here. 8% more dampening, but Looney's expended a lot of mana trying to get aggressive before that point. Perhaps he should have just been patient and waited it out. We'll have to wait and see. Swapsy trades, overlapped with Ironbark. Big mistake, stack up for a double stun. Good punish by Looney. Where's the follow-up? No one's in line of sight to get follow-up crowd control. Wildcard Gaming are just dogpiling on top of Method Black here to close it out. Huge lightning last away in the crane once again. Looney goes all in for the kill. How can Chaz keep him up? He's got the tiniest bit of mana left to do it. If they don't get a kill here, Looney's almost tapped on mana. Swapsy on the run. He's managed to avoid death. Chaz recovers. Mana evens out. This is still anyone's match.
Yeah, definitely. Now full bash on to Chaz. Do they have any follow-up crowd control? Maro getting pressured down. He might have been playing a little bit too aggressive here. Looney with no safety nets left. There's no Way of the Crane for 30 seconds. No Life Cocoon for 50 seconds. Method Black now have an opportunity to get really aggressive. Looney also has no trinket, so even if he can get the Way of the Crane, if Raikou and Swapsy can find some crowd control, they might be able to just deny it. Meantime, though, Swapsy getting bursted down. Huge damage coming in from Maro. Swapsy's still just trying to run, use this pillar to avoid any incoming spell damage from Wildcard Gaming. He does manage to stabilize. Method Black stay in.
1% dampening away from the magic 40% marker, but Z-Pi could die before it. He pre-astral shifts the incoming stun, stabilizes. One more Way of the Crane possibly left in the tank for Looney. They could combine it with Innervate. They are going to have a Way of the Crane. They go for it. It's all or nothing at this point for Wildcard Gaming. It's the 40% mark. They need to take Swapsy down. Will they be able to do it? Triple stun. Nice Ring of Peace onto the anti-magic zone. Good denial. Follow-up stun. Perfect execution. Swapsy holds on by a thread. How on earth is he still alive at this point? Overlapping now with the Ironbark anti-magic shield. That defense will be fading shortly, and once it is gone, there is nothing left for Swapsy to stay alive. It's just going to be a dance with death, and Swapsy needs to make the decision soon. Does he push forward, or does he try and run and hide? It looks like pushing forward is the option of choice currently. Chaz is trying to sneak for a drink. Maro's getting pressured. He's not able to allow Looney to sit down for a drink. Would have liked to have seen this lightning lasso on Swapsy instead. Potentially the interrupts available dictated that one, but now Chaz has to heal two members with zero mana. Looney has to do the same, and surprisingly, this is still anyone's fight.
Swapsy in a lot of trouble. A beautiful Ring of Peace coming in from Looney once again, denying the darkness of Raikou. Swapsy has to retreat. Z-Pi, Looney all over him. Way the Crane gets used. Can they take him down? Yes, they do. Wildcard Gaming with this Moonkin Elemental Shaman 3-0. Method Black sending them to the lower bracket.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.